this CETL VODcast, we're going to talk about creating a neutral third-party calendar inside your own calendar. So that means a calendar that you might use for staffing or for coordinating other events or anything that you maybe don't necessarily have to show up to, but things that you want to coordinate in a calendar situation. So let's do this. We're going to create a neutral third-party calendar. We're going to control access to that calendar. We're going to email your friends about that calendar so they can also look at that calendar. Then we're going to talk about some caveats. You can't invite that calendar, so we'll talk about how that limits it. And creating things on the calendar means you have to click to create it. And the third caveat is you don't show up as busy at that time. So if you think that you're going to schedule yourself on this secondary calendar, you're not. You don't show up as busy to the rest of the world. Let's get started. I'm going into the calendar function. And within this calendar function, I'm going to right-click on Calendar, which is my primary calendar, and I'm going to click on New Calendar. This calendar, I'm going to pretend, is my project timeline. I'm just making that up, but it's going to go inside of my calendar. It's going to contain calendar items, so that's all correct. I'll say OK. Once Outlook has a chance to think about that, here it is at the bottom of my navigation pane, and so I'm going to check to open up Project Timeline. So now I have Project Timeline. It's not in overlay mode, so I can either view it in overlay mode or not view it in overlay mode. If I needed to add things to this Project Timeline, I could just simply click on the day and add an event. So that's a full day event. Let's go down. Well, it's already due. And the other thing I could do was add a meeting. So there's an event and a meeting, which I'm both overdue for. So let's talk about sharing this with friends now. So I need this project timeline to go to other folks in my office. So if I right-click on this, I can go to Share, and I can share the calendar. So I get the email calendar and the share calendar. Be aware that those are two different functions. Email calendar is going to package it up and send it along, so it's kind of like a static copy. Share calendar means I add something to the project timeline and you see it. So let's click on share calendar. Okay, and so now I'm going to add some other folks in my office, and they get to see that. The other thing, I might want the recipients on this list to add, edit, delete items in this calendar. Here's the project. So when I hit send, this is going to prompt them to open this calendar inside of their Outlook calendar. So I'll say yes, and there it goes. The other item here in Project Timeline, I'm going to right-click on that Project Timeline again and go to Properties. And inside of Properties, I have Permissions. And as I see, I have all kinds of folks that are already set up as reviewers. Anyone that was added on my calendar as a reviewer is also showing up in here as a reviewer. But they can't really open that until I send them that email that I've just done. So be aware that that email is very functional. So to share that calendar, I right-click on the calendar, go to Share, and say Share Calendar. And this calendar permissions is going to take me to the same place that I just was. Okay, so I've added some caveats. Let's talk caveats. Now I've just shared this with Brant and Alan. If Brant and Alan want to put something on this, there's no way to email that information directly to the calendar. They will have to physically type the meeting into this calendar. Okay? So, yes, okay. And that's the only way to kind of add things onto this. Now, maybe I wanted to share this with someone outside of my organization. In that situation, the share email calendar, this is appropriate. And this goes through a really neat little function which zips up the calendar into an HTML layout and lets them see things of what's going on and when. And that's that email calendar function. So again, I did chair email calendar. That's for folks outside of our organization who don't need to be actively aware of the calendar. So let's go back to our mail and make sure we hit everything. And again, if I did a busy search, I would not show up as busy in those times that I've entered information into my secondary calendar. So it's not going to reflect on me. And I can't invite anything to calendar. I've been asked this a lot of times. I've really looked for the answer, and I haven't. But hey, if you know the answer, I'm interested. That's about it. Contact CETL for any other information you need.